Thanks a lot, and a good show. Let's now join Scully Levine.
Okay, folks, wonderful time for you yesterday. We certainly had a ball, and
yeah, let's now go over to Ellis. Well done.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Fantastic once again flying here for you today. We hope you've enjoyed this display brought to you by Gable Stock Absorbers. And see you later, Brian.
Thanks, guys. Well done. Thanks, Brian. Chris Breers in the X-Doll. You won't even get out of this airport in 57 minutes. Well, Glenn, you're live with us. Good afternoon and welcome.
Good afternoon, folks. It's good to be here again. Unfortunately, you're going to stay for too long. We're going to skid off to it tonight, but I'm sure you enjoy the short display.
As great as always, my friend. $400 litres, not too shabby. Not paying that for. Speed now?
440.
Well, thanks, Glenn, from all of us, and there are a few of us that know how much effort you put in. Well done, and thanks, buddy. Have a safe one. Over there, they'll sign posters. They've got caps, key rings, badges, all sorts of goodies.
Let's go and see the stars, the Milky Way, or even Mars. Where it could just be ours.
All alone, and the sun went down.
Just shows you how much and how much they love you.
Would be Chris Williams.
get out there and you get the job done. A really, really good guy. And he's also got a heart attack for the rest. Canadian glasses in trying to land on the back on the tip of the missile on the phone. Because they realize that the new really good shots are really going to do it. Look at this for sure. Look at this for sure. Tell you that Durban Metro are absolutely inundated now with phone calls of huge. Now on board that aircraft we have the jump master from the top.
Albatross as they approach us from the right. Patrols. Earlier today we saw PP Dakota, that's with the turboprop engines that flew past here. That was on an actual coastal patrol at the moment. And the Dakotas actually replaced the Albatross. Particular aircraft are well known on the airshow scene. Two real gentlemen, Ralph Dominique and Brian Brewer. They often assist us, with myself being based in Johannesburg, having to get to air shows. They're kind enough to give us a seat. Everybody had a breakdown of an aircraft. They are willing to fly and go and get spare parts for that aircraft. So, two wonderful guys, and as well as engines. These two aircraft are painted in the line now. You know, the formation flying is usually taught in the Air Force, and here we have two civilian pilots showing us how they have been trained and are really doing an excellent job of flying a tight formation. Kilometers an hour, about 270 kilometers an hour is their cruising speed as we watch them approaching us head on here. basically gone to final approach for his approach for runway 05. And we've just had a call here from Haley saying to us they've only got 40 Smoke On Go Airshow books left. So folks, if you do not have your book yet, now is the time. Only 40 left. So pop over for 50 rand, you can get all of the time for you. And we have a touchdown by Alpha Charlie India. That's Brian Brewer. And we thank them for a lovely show.
South African Police Task Force. That's good. Pixie's mark. There you are. Great. Thanks a lot to General Les Lombard watching this. Parachute us now as he comes down here from the South African Police Special Task Force. Beautiful. Just look at that. The first guy to land. South African flag as its spinnaker. What a beautiful, beautiful sight this is. Often when we go to work in other countries, we try and think back if there's anywhere else in the world where you can stand and do an air show and have the yacht so close, have the Navy out there, and have Garris at this moment. He's gonna tell him as they come in to land, he'll tell him to lift his legs. And the reason he does that is because he's got, there you are. I told him, and I was going to say, come lift them up, lift them up. They're going to land on their backside. There you are. See, done that before. Very, very interesting one. Very merry as they're coming down in that specially hired bus. Right, there you see now, the bus has come under attack. This is countdown to 2010. You see the bad guys attacking the bus. They know that there are tourists on that bus. They know that if they get out there, they can really get some good loot.
They prowl the empty streets at night, waiting in fast cars, on foot, living with crime and violence. These men are on duty 24 hours out of every 24. They face dangers at every turn, expecting nothing less. They protect the people of South Africa. These are the men of squad cars.
Well, folks, now you see, as the guys come in to strike like lightning, members of the South African Police Task Force in their specially equipped vehicle. Hey, it's got a serious set of brakes on it. There's a guy that's trying to get away, the dog handler, and the dog picks up the target. He's going in. This guy's got to run. This dog's going to take him out right in front of us. Down he goes. Oh, now that dog is angry. That was a miss, and he's biting this guy. Dog handler moves in while there's a serious gunfight down there. Members of the police task force using that specially equipped vehicle. These are the Durban based guys. So the vehicle that we're using there, And there we see strike like lightning. That's what the task force are all about. Now we bring in our two helicopters. This is the reinforcement. So we've got a combination now of the National Intervention Unit and the task force. Using R5s at the moment. The task force are one of the unit helicopters now giving all-round defense from the air. There are guys that have been shot, stun grenades being thrown. Now the members of Venus of the task force for 2010. It's countdown, it's early days, and the guys are showing that they're completely ready, and it's also showing the close cooperation between Search and Rescue Dog Squad, Task Force, and NIU. Working, of course, Search and Rescue guys at the bottom. Command and control there from the second helicopter. This is close cooperation between all these various units. Gently they do it, up they go nicely. Task force on the ground that have taken a form of defense. Now the four members will immediately move back to their helicopter, armed with R4 rifles, and they also have got nice Glock 9mm. The Sharkies really have a great choice. They also have Heckler and Koch. There they show us as they just fly past. And that's Brad. That's no, it's not. It's Michael Michael O'Donnell. Michael O'Donnell that's flying over there. You'll see how the guys have all formed. I can't believe it. I've asked these guys so nicely to go to the bottom of the runway. I don't know what to do. They die.
Yeah.
takes the turn of Buzz Poseidon once again. And watch how he takes this little Robbie, the R22, and he just dances in the sky. Mandy will take you through the commentary as we watch Buzz Poseidon. Yaku Tropa. Yaku's got just under 6,000 hours as a helicopter pilot.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you'll see that this is also one of the most maneuverable helicopters. The wheels come off pilots. A lot of training is done on this R22s, and these aircraft are used extensively throughout South Africa. And the person flying that aircraft, nobody else but Buzz Poseidon. And Buzz has got close on 18,000 hours of rotary wings. He's a rank one instructor and he's rated on most of the Gull helicopters in South Africa, as well as on R42, R44, Armstrong, Rotary, Way Jet 90, etc., etc. A very, very highly qualified pilot. And this aircraft is also from Starlight, which is located just on the northern side of the airfield, next to the runway there, a fantastic company that does a lot of training of pilots, and there's a lot of charter work on helicopters and contractual work outside of the country, in humanitarian work, etc. The local Robertson R22 is an aircraft manufactured in the United States of America. There's 131 horsepower motor. It uses at about 95 knots. And the max speed of this aircraft is 150 knots. It's about 190 kilos per hour. The aircraft seats two people with the flying instructor and the student pilot. And this aircraft's got an empty weight of about 370 kilograms. The max roll-up weight, the gross weight of this aircraft. The R22 has also now become one of the best-selling civil helicopters in the market. Its high performance and reliability, the quality of the helicopter, makes it the choice of private and commercial helicopter operators all over the world. Look at that, you can see how maneuverable this aircraft really is. To the guys at Starlight, dying to get ready. And what a fantastic opportunity to have to show these guys to Starlight as well.
This automatic aircraft that has been developed by AeroCam, based at Wonderboom in Pretoria. They specialize in the Batting Club. We are watching Johnny Smith. Little plane has. that's a knife-edge fly past down the runway.
Guys, for Jeff and for Junior and for Vern. So we'll join Scully Levine, Arnie Menegeli, Stu Lithgow. We'll go live. Believe that the Yak missing man will be just after this. Will be heading back to his businesses, the Wimpy's back in Saint-Lambert, Margate, as we're watching the harvests now, tight formation. Highly accomplished airline pilot, over 20,000 hours. Now the harvest, 2.5 tons. Powered by a Pratt & Whitney radial engine, some 550 horsepower. It's the R1340 nine-cylinder. Fuel consumption is around 55 US gallons per hour. Inverted. Stu, having done aerobatics in the harbour, maybe you'd like to... Hundreds of shows. Fantastic aeroplane, old, built like an absolute brick. What's it?
Break, go!
There we go for the 2010 break, right over the hospitality center where the VIP guests from Durban are having lunch.
In the history that I've seen it have done.
Sponsored by Cash Stroll Aviator and Academy Brushware. Just gently.
Three airline pilots and one serious businessman.
From a toothbrush to great big brooms that sweep the roads of South Africa. Then now we watch the three shipper.
Thank you.
here now is, and I do it at every air show, I try to do something different, something new. And I've just spoken to Stuart and said, we've got 8 harvards here, we've got 8 yachts here. Why don't we tomorrow put up 16 and have east, west, and have a 16 ship? That made for some good photographs. Airline pilot, trained in the South African Air Force, inhaling smoke. That's diesel that's pumped out across the exhaust system of the aircraft. Now that is very, very close. Have a look at how well these guys fly. The man in the middle is the leader, and the two wingmen, left and right, they'll have their heads locked onto that aeroplane. They are not watching anything but those wingtips. I always enjoy is you just go up and suddenly just feel as you get pushed into the seat. Now you're floating, you're just hanging there, hanging on those straps. You start pushing down, you see the ground is now rushing towards you. And you level out. The North American Harvard. The aircraft that was used as a basic primary trainer. Well, as these Harvards come down here towards us, American control. Aircraft raffle. It's a Piper Cherokee 235, and there are now very few tickets left. Make sure you get your ticket. Thank you, Deborah. Flying with Goodyear tires. Now changing into diamond formation.
Oh, Scully, next, left.
the missing man formation.
Oh, they are ready to pull.
A document to make
perfected it. And that is a demonstration of the conviction, the passion, absolutely.
Play by the Boeing 737-200 and 300.
It's flown here now by Mike Weingart. Mike, who has an incredible CV. In fact, he's a colleague of Leon Duplessis that's sitting next to me over here. They work together.
Leon's got all 48 kilometers an hour, and it can travel, it's got a range of 900 kilometers. Powered by a Rolls-Royce Viper 20 Mark 540 turbojet engine, and it's rated at 2,000 feet.
The next bit is the list of the
This man's got the world record of just
over 5,000 hours on this type of aircraft. Nobody in the world has as many hours as Mike. Mike is a senior maintenance test pilot with the Denel Aviation, and he served in the aviation since 1970. He's been involved in military flying instruction since 1976. He's flown the Hawk, and he flies part-time for the South African Airways historic flight, and he's flown for other regional airlines as first officer on the DC-3 and DC-4. At Lund University, Sweden. So I can now tell you that he has completed his master's degree, and that's my friend Mike Weingart.
David's father was served in the Air Force as a technician, and his father, the original backup requirement that the wife in South Africa, his father actually assisted with the assembly. So when the Impala became available, David put in a bid and managed to purchase this aeroplane. And this is now the only flying privately owned Impala in South Africa.
Aft for short takeoff. As soon as we get the clearance.
Folks, watch this aeroplane. This is amazing.
It's gonna be so loud.
You can go through.
Folks, watch this. This aeroplane takes off in about 20 meters. Shorter than a helicopter. Watch, and it's flown by the master, Chris Breers. It's the only aeroplane that when you select the Garmin map, it doesn't show takeoff.
The only thing that upsets me about this is that this aeroplane was developed and originates and designed in New Zealand.
Watch as he gets ready now. Normally it's one line of the runway. Here we go. Here we go. Let's see if he's gonna get the wheel up before the end of the line. He does. front wheel up, two lines on the runway. Display pilot extraordinaire, flown in 17 races. He's flown in most parts of the world. He was heavily involved in the tsunami in Indonesia, the earthquake in Pakistan. He founded a company called NatureLink. Now works for NAC as a consultant. Watch what he does with this aeroplane. Chris Breers. This is an unbelievable aeroplane, and when you go for the landing, it's even shorter. It's a fact. One crew, 10 passengers, Pratt & Whitney, PT6-34, 750 sharp horsepower. It's a Hartzell three-blade metal constant speed, full feathering propeller. The fuselage is aluminium alloy, skin panels riveted together. Carries 861 litres of fuel, a distance of 800 nautical miles, a ceiling of 1,000 feet. Maximum speed 170 knots, cruising speed 165 knots. Land on, watch what he's going to do. He's going to push it. This is what I call underneath the radar. This is how he comes down. He's got the white line. Now watch. Watch how short he's going to land. He comes down. He's decided no. This is a good pilot. Oh boy, this is very, very good. He brought it down, holds it, and now he just hovers it down. Right, let's see if he's going to come down, do the landing on those Goodyear tires. Comes down, picks up his mark nicely. Is he going to? Less than a line. Okay, what can I say? And now he just reverses it. And I have just heard, there you are, puts it in the garage on his private golf course. And he says, put that in your pipe and smoke it. Thank you, Chris Breers, good show. Now getting there more. Folks, now it's the turn of Franz Hasbroek. Nick Vermaak in the Pilatus Porter. Right, watching the police Porter as he approaches now from the left-hand side. In fact, it's not Nick for us. He's actually today been very busy because as chief pilot, he's flown Romeo into Charlie, Romeo Delta in Lima, and now he's in November India X-ray. As he takes the aircraft from the South African police airwing. This particular aeroplane is based up at Bonnebrum, home of the air wing in Pretoria. Brian Norden, senior superintendent, he heads up the fixed wing section where we've got the Sovereign, the Learjet, the Beachjet, and a whole lot of Porter. That's a great aircraft for crime prevention because as you're traveling around, you travel slow. It's got a lot of radio equipment inside. It carries repeaters. And there he shows us power by just turning slightly. The guys, in fact, in the back don't really enjoy flying, because if we put policemen in the back that don't enjoy flying, they become reasonably ill, and the sortie has to get abandoned. But however, we're very lucky that at all the sectors there are policemen from the various units and stations that are accustomed to flying. And the crew would be the commander of the aircraft and an ALIO, an airborne law enforcement officer. Now these aircraft carry a huge variety of nav aids, as well as a lot of good radio equipment. The ALIO will be looking after all the radio work, while the commander will be making sure that he stays within the airspace. Now a lot of people often see the police aircraft flying extremely. This is now low and slow. Now I can tell you that the two Boeings are getting ready. I'm just listening on the radio over here, and I hear Durban ground getting ready to push back the two Boeing 737s. This is going to really be something else. Two Boeing 737s, five Silver Falcons, and two Harvards.
This is great. I'm giving you a background.
Well, that's just a country going the wrong way. But this is Nick from Mark. So, sorry, Nick. Make sure these fronts came along and told us that he's not flying. That's Nick Vermaak that we were watching. Nick is based in Pretoria. He's at Vonneboom. And a big thank. He gets airborne. Are they going to work their way back? It looks like it is. So five gets airborne. This will be Falcon 4, Karat Lawrence. Now it will be three, Captain Butitsebe. Two, Captain Roy Sproul. One. Major Scott Benet. North. The safety officer will be Captain Sandy Bain, and Senior First Officer Debbie Berkowitz, Robinson R44. Both former fighter pilots from the South African Air Force. I saw Glenn flying the Mirage and diving down in the middle here with over 20,000 flying hours. He's Captain Dennis Spence. So now we've got three airline pilots up there. Neil Trollope, the first officer with South African Airways. Dennis Spence, a captain on the A340. And Glenn Warden out on the right-hand side. We stay live with Dennis Spence, Glenn Warden, and Neil Trollope.
Yeah, turning into the mirror. go. Position. He's ready. This flight, go.
Watch the two ship. Now that looks very close, but believe me, it is. On Friday morning, we were flying over the stadium. Special lady in your life, I'll tell you what to do. Get your cameras ready, this is always very special. Special lady with you. You just dedicate this to her. This is the Goodyear Eagle Heartbreak in Beverly. It's fun. Well, you couldn't wish for a better one. From the right hand side.
Say goodbye. It's been fantastic being here today. Radio first for my good partner and friend, Neil Zorn, coming in from the right side. Brian, Bobby. This time, Brian, standing in my place. He's in a steady position. He's getting one down there. And we've had a good year. Have a seat, folks.
Discovered great passion and I just love it. Every second of working. Friendly reminder to the people that are walking there without hoops on you.